Halfway through this construction project, things are going very well at Chimney Hollow Reservoir project. We're still within a couple weeks of finishing this project on time in summer of 2025, and we're still within about 5 to 10% of our estimated budget for the Chimney Hollow Reservoir project.
The metamorphosis of the valley from groundbreaking to today, August 2023, is nothing short of amazing. Two years seems like a long time, but it's gone really fast out here.
We are now about 120 feet over that foundation in what will ultimately be a 350 foot tall dam.
It's been an amazing 2 years out here. So much has happened in that short amount of time.
Right now we have about 500 workers and 200 pieces of mobile equipment working 24 hours a day, 6 days a week, to help us build the largest reservoir that's been built in the United States this century.
We're getting into a point where we're kind of hitting our stride and getting to our peak production, so that's all very exciting.
It's like a small city out here, and constantly moving, constantly growing, constantly getting closer to our finish line. So it's August 2023. We started construction 2 years ago in 2021. The feeling out here is very positive because we spent the better part of a year basically going down and getting everything ready for the dam to come up. And 2 years in, we're a year into building now and we're up. I think the common thing at this 2 year point is everything is coming up. The valve house is coming up, the dam is coming up, the embankment's coming up.
We started placing embankment materials last October. We are now about 120 feet over that foundation in what will ultimately be a 350 foot tall dam. And that consists of an asphalt core as our central zone, and then several transition zones out to our main rock fill embankment, which is a 24 inch maximum size rock fill embankment. We've placed over 2 million cubic yards of rock fill and 8,000 cubic yards of hydraulic asphalt in the core of the dam. The dam right now is going up at a rate of about 20 feet per month.
So the last 2 years have been very busy with not only the main dam embankment, but all the other features of work that are going out here. I mean, yes, this is Chimney Hollow Reservoir. We are building a 350 foot tall asphalt core dam, but it's not just the dam.
Each feature of work at the Chimney Hollow project in itself could be a major public works project. We have a saddle dam located on the south end of the reservoir, and that saddle dam allows us to store the 90,000 acre feet that we need to meet the water supply criteria for the project. The saddle dam is a much smaller structure than the main dam at Chimney Hollow. The saddle dam is about a 35 foot clay core rock fill dam. We are just now wrapping up the foundation excavation and are planning to start grouting in the saddle dam next month. We have gotten the quarry development completed to the point where it can deliver 63,000 tons per day and be operated as one of the largest mining operations in the state of Colorado.
It's changed a lot and will continue to change. We blast every day to make sure there's enough rock for the dam.
We have an on-site aggregate processing facility that is established and is producing all of the concrete aggregates, the asphalt aggregates, and all of the sand and gravel filters that are necessary to meet the project demands. The water that will ultimately go into the Chimney Hollow Reservoir starts on the west slope in our Windy Gap project. So we pump water from Windy Gap into the Colorado Big Thompson project. At the Bald Mountain Tunnel, we divert water out of the CBT system into Chimney Hollow Reservoir.
The Chimney Hollow conduit, so that's the conduit that ties Bald Mountain into the new Chimney Hollow system, that is almost complete. So all of the pipe has been laid. There's a handful of thrust blocks remaining.
We have placed about 1 mile of 6-foot diameter buried steel pipe for the project, and that pipeline brings water from the CBT project into the Chimney Hollow Reservoir project.
This year, about halfway in the project, we started the valve house. The valve house is the heart of the reservoir infrastructure. It's over 45 feet tall, 12,000 square feet.
Ultimately, to control all of the flows in and out of the project, we are going to install 61 valves associated with this project. Most of those valves are going to be located in a valve house at the toe of the dam. The foundation work for the valve house is now complete, and the walls are starting to come up on that structure. We get water in and out of the Chimney Hollow Reservoir through a 2,000-foot long tunnel. The excavation and ground support for the tunnel is approximately halfway done and should be completed by the end of the year. Once the excavation and ground support is completed in the tunnel, we're going to run a 72-inch steel pipe through that tunnel to actually carry the water. We'll also put a reinforced concrete lining, and then all of the electrical and mechanical support features will be installed in the tunnel. We have a spillway located on the main dam. The purpose of the spillway is to convey large storm flows around the embankment when the embankment is full during operations. The spillway is about 10% complete right now.
Excited to see the spillway to continue to progress. So we've gotten through a lot of the foundation, and now we're into actually placing box culvert, which is kind of the final component. We're pretty darn close to where we need to be. The weather this spring did slow us down a bit. I think on site we're at somewhere around 20 inches of rain, most of which fell in a 8-10 week period. Unusual for the local area, but we've pretty well got through it and stayed on track.
Other challenges that the team has addressed is working through some difficult foundation conditions for the main dam. But despite all of these challenges, we're still within a couple weeks of finishing this project on time in summer of 2025. And we're still within about 5-10% of our estimated budget for the Chimney Hollow Reservoir project.
Now, to get all this work done, we depend a lot on the crews. These guys and gals are working really hard out here, 24 hours a day, and the crews are what is making this possible.
The progress that we've made at the Chimney Hollow project is truly an example of teamwork and is an example of the strong character that our team has to work through all of these difficulties and still deliver this project. So success at Chimney Hollow means a lot of different things. Of course, we are working to control costs and to get the project done on time, but we also work to foster a culture that defines success as promoting a safe working environment, to stay quality focused, to minimize the impacts on the local community, and to keep environmental stewardship in the forefront of our work.
A lot has happened in the previous 2 years, but we still have a long way to go, and I'm really looking forward to just watching this continue upwards and get to the top and develop into an important project for Northern Colorado.
The population of Northern Colorado is growing. The Chimney Hollow Reservoir Project provides a solution to addressing the water supply needs for our future generations. I'm very proud to work for Northern Water and support the work that we do. Northern Colorado is my home and my family's home, and I feel very fortunate to be able to lead this project and support our community in this manner.
I'm from Colorado, so I grew up 40 miles south of here. It's been unique to come home and to be able to do something like this in Colorado.
We're building this for our community and for our kids and our kids' kids for generations to come, and it's going to enable Colorado to continue to be a spectacular place and a wonderful place to live.